We are working with migration on post-stack section. After normal move-out, deep move-out, and stacking, now zero offset record. So we would like to define migration. So migration is a process, is a geometrical process in which the deviated position of reflector points in the subsurface is returned to its proper location. It can also be described as an inverse extrapolation method in which we extrapolate the field from the surface into its subsurface reflection position. So due to many wave interaction with the subsurface structure, the point we thought we are sampling in the subsurface is somehow deviated from its actual position, actual location. For example, as an example, those due to dipping, those due to diffraction, and those due to irregular interfaces. So the points, for example, in the classical representation, when we speak about migration, we usually go for the basin shape or the anticline, syncline shape. So if we have, this is the Earth's surface, and this is the actual subsurface, and here is the source, and here are the receivers. So energies at this point, for example, will not be recorded at the geophone, the proper one in the midpoint, because this point is located between and midpoint between this shot and this geophone, for example. But according to this dipping, it will move to the furthest geophone. So when collecting, we are collecting this point at location that is not the actual location of this point. Okay? And also the situation for points here, it will be also misplaced according to the geometry. In time domain, the situation will look something like this. So our intention is to migrate this into its proper location so that we have in time section this shape. And this occurs by putting this, migrating this point here and migrating this point here and also migrating other points into their proper location. Okay? So this is the main idea behind migration. Okay or not? Bagus? Okay? Then we have discussed two approaches. One kinematic, which is interested only in time, and the other one is the wave equation, which interested in both time and amplitude. Today's lecture will be focused on techniques that is based on wave equation, depending on Kirchhoff or Kirchhoff approximation or equation for representing the wave equation. We also need to define the time and depth migration. Generally speaking, time and depth migration do the same task, except that in time migration, the vertical axis is time, while in depth migration, the vertical axis is depth. And we can understand that in order to move or convert time into depth, you need velocity. So in depth migration, extra term related to velocity is applied so that we are moving or transforming the time into depth. And migration in general depends on the velocity model. Hence, a good result depends on the reliability of that model. However, depth migration is much more sensitive to velocity model because it's dependent on this velocity twice. It's not depending only on returning points into their proper location, but also into moving from time domain into depth domain. So far, so good. Are you following me? Okay. So what are the migration steps? We have, or we follow usually, two steps. The first one is to inverse extrapolate of the input data, meaning that the stacked section representing zero offset section from surface level into certain depths or vertical time level. If you remember the exploding reflector, we, in this exploding reflector migration, we assume that the reflector is composed of points, and the energy recorded at the surface is not moving from source to reflector and then to the receiver. Rather, we assume that the source lies at those point at the reflector, and at the time t equals zero, the energy begins to propagate from these points directly upward to be recorded at the surface. This is the exploding reflector model. Exploding meaning that we are firing or shooting for all points or number of points discretizing this reflector. So, like in fiction movie, if I'm moving in this direction, in fiction movie, you can speak about inverse time, but you will get me back in time to my start position. So this is the idea that you propagate or inverse extrapolate the energy from the surface until you return at time zero, where the point at time zero will be at the reflector itself. So successful application will return you, will give you points at the reflector at their proper location. The second point is to select the T equals zero component, which is a migrated result for that depth or vertical time level. Okay? Okay, Mohammed? Okay? So, what are the procedures we are following to do so? First, we consider a stacked section, and eventually, after deep move-out correction, and this stacked section is a zero offset section. And this will be correct in travel time, but not in amplitude. The second point, consider a zero offset section to be an exploding reflector measurements, in which all reflectors in the subsurface are considered to be sources that explode at T equal zero. So we don't have T equal zero for all the section. We don't have one T equal zero for all section. Rather, we have many T equal zero as many as the reflectors we are dealing with in the section. Okay? Are you following me? At the corner, are you following me? No. No or yes? Yes. Yes, following or no, not following? Yes? You follow me? Okay. This again is good for explaining the travel times in a zero offset section, but not perfect also for amplitudes. And then another procedure is the inverse, extrapolate the wave field measured at the subsurface, at the surface, which means zero offset section, to a depth level in the earth by means of the migration formula at in your book, it's the book I gave you, it's at equation 472. And then we select the T equals zero component of this extrapolated wave field, which will contain the exploding reflector contribution of the depth level under consideration. And then we save this T equals zero component in the migrated output section. So for each T equals zero component, we are going to save the result, and then the image will be constructed by many T equals zero components, as we are going to see in one of the figures we are going to see. Repeat the last two steps for all depths, for all depth levels, such that the complete migration result is constructed for all depth levels. This illustrates the last three points. The first graph represents the unmigrated section. The second one represents migration at this level, at 0.4 second level, and this one represents, you see these points, now it's thicker, it's bold, more bold. Thus, part of the record is at T equals zero component, which is migrated to their proper location. When we move downward to about 0.6, now more points are migrated at T equals zero for this level. Then, when we arrive, now we are inverse extrapolation from up to down. Then when we arrive to 1.2, we have all the section migrated, the reflector is fully migrated as you can see. So the migration here is constructed for each successive level we are assigning. And for each level, we apply the extrapolation equation, and this extrapolation equation has t equals zero component. We keep the t equals zero component, which means or signify the position of the point for this level, for the points of this level, and so on until we finish all the section and the reflection is in actual or proper location. Of course, this is a synthetic model. It's not a true model, and it is done like that for illustration, but it's not the actual situation. So, what are the types of migration techniques? We have many types of migration techniques, but first, we have to specify or emphasize that all migration techniques discussed today are based on Kirchhoff equation. The type of handling of this equation describe each control, each technique. So, how we are going to solve this integration? And this, if you remember, Kirchhoff is one source or one image of the wave equation. And the wave equation can be solved using integral methods and differentiation methods. For integral methods, generally speaking, we are applying for or looking for exact solution, and this exact solution is restricted to more simple models. So if the model exhibit or contains large change or high change in velocity throughout the space of the problem, we may not be able to solve the problem with integration. Okay, so we go for differentiation methods, which is usually depends on numerical techniques like the finite difference method. I'm not sure you studied or you have any idea about finite difference method or not. But I will try to touch in our discussion. Diving deep in mathematical formula is not the focus of in the present course. Thus, only the overall idea will be discussed. This represent the Kirchhoff equation, and this is what we are looking for solution to obtain or to migrate the section into proper location, both in time and amplitude. Migration techniques discussed here are applied to both stacked section. It also accounts for amplitude and time rather than time alone. This is because we are dealing with the wave equation. These techniques we are going to discuss are time migration via the F, KX, KY domain, and it's named. Is there any problem? And it's named after Gazdag. This is a scientist, and it's called phase shift migration. And the second one is the time migration by Fourier transform. Stolt, this is the name of scientist, Stolt migration. We have recursive depth migration in the space frequency domain. And then the above three are integration in nature or integral in nature. The other two, finite difference time migration and finite difference depth migration. The last are using differentiation. In fact, there is a lot of mathematical derivation here, so I try to summarize what this method do and keep you away from this mathematical derivation. And the time migration via the FKX KY domain, we solve the Kirchhoff equation, but now here we have the space, we have X and we have Y, and vertically we have Z, and then we have the force dimension, which is called the time. Okay? So to understand this, this is the space, this class is our space. All of us take position in this space. Suppose this is the origin, so I'll be at certain X, Y, and Z, and each one of you will be the same. After 12 o'clock, we are all, maybe all of us will be out, or maybe I will be out, and Professor Nuruddin will be in. So we have the space, but we have variation due to the time. You understand? After that, after the next lecture, we have the space, but you are not here. One will go to lunch, one will go to play, and so on and so on. So these are the four dimensions, three for space and one for time. And time looks like having a snapshot for each moment to see what changed in the space, how the space changed. So in our case, where we have, we will speak about time, X, and Y, since these are the location of our observations, our records. So it will be time, X, and Y. When we apply Fourier transform for space and time, time will be frequency, X will be KX, wave number in the X direction, and Y will be KY, which is the wave number in the Y direction. Okay? So we are going to transform in the F, KX, KY, and then we are going to apply the phase shift function. In this method, the Kirchhoff equation representing the pressure or wave field is forward transformed into frequency wave number domain. A phase shift function is estimated and then multiplied by the transformed wave field. Full stop. In our migration, or in our in processing generally, you can say, speak generally, we we always have image of that or the desired image of the subsurface. So according to this desired image, we are designing the techniques and taking the parameters to arrive to this desired image. So we are going to apply the phase shift function to tailor this phase shift function so that we can use with our data in order to migrate the section into the proper space and time domain. The phase shift function is a function of kx, ky, delta z, and f equal exponential plus 2 pi I lambda delta t, where lambda can be seen as representation of vertical or frequency, representation of frequency vertical wave number term to represent the vertical term. If we plot this function, this is a plot of this function, you will see that here we have ky wave number, and here we have kx wave number, and here we have the normalized amplitude. And this part between certain ky and 1 and 2 and certain kx 1 and 2 is a flat part. When it's multiplied in frequency wave number domain with the Kirchhoff transformed also relation, it will migrate the data in their position, and then by inverse migration we will obtain the desired results. Okay? The second method is the time migration by Fourier transform. In case we have constant speed, the previous representation of the wave field transformation can be more simplified, and this method or this migration is then applied as follows. But before go forward, I have to stop and return to the definition or the meaning of this sentence. One of the problems we have is the change of velocity. So if we assume that the velocity is constant for certain layer, this means that the integration itself is more simple, and we don't need, for example, suppose a media is here. This is a media with constant velocity or constant speed, and we have from point B to point Q, and you want to define the time. So it's simply this distance divided by velocity. Okay, and this is integration. The integration here will be to constant value, so we do not have to carry out integration. So what is the situation if we have change in velocity? Okay. So for each block, will have to carry out the integration, and then we will sum up the time, and in this case also the bus will not maybe not in this way, because you understand that we have both Snell law and Fermat bus. So according to this distribution, the bus might change to this form, and so the integration becomes more complicated, because we have V1 between this point and this point, another V between this point and this point, third V, fourth, five, fifth, and sixth in this example. So the integration will have to account for all of this, or will have to be cut to, in this case, to six segments to define the final time component we are looking for. So in case we don't have complexity in velocity and we have velocity equal or the same or constant, we might end up with scalar components of the wave equation, and this is most simple to solve. So do you understand this, or do you have any problem? Anybody? Azra'i? By the way, what's the meaning of Azra'i, or it's just name? Is it has meaning, or your name has meaning, or just name? Just name. Okay. Now returning back. So the migration here will be carried out as follows. So here we are speaking about simple equation, and this is simple step in applying the in applying the migration. First, we make forward Fourier transform from xyt to kx, ky, f of the zero offset data. Second, we interpolate from BKXKYF to BKXKY lambda, where lambda here equals F square minus KX square C square divided by 4 minus K square Y C square divided by 4. And why we have 4 here? It should be k square c square, kx square c square, ky square c square only, because if you remember in exploding reflector, we assumed that the velocity is half the actual velocity. So the square result in c square divided by 4. Then we interpolate, meaning interpolate means you have points defined, and you want to estimate points in between. If you are outside, it will be extrapolation. So finding these points is called interpolation. Scale this result with the Jacobi factor of equation, and Jacobi factor of equation is defined as the differentiation of delta F by delta lambda. And finally, we inverse Fourier transform from KXKY lambda to XYT domain. Applying this, we will end up with the proper migrated section. The nice feature of this formulation is that it describes an inverse Fourier transform over the coordinates kx, ky, lambda, yielding the complete migration for all delta t values. The results are given as given above is the constant velocity stall time migration. So it's very important to point out that we don't mean that all the section will have constant velocity, but we can assume certain band or certain region big enough to exhibit constant velocity. Then we move to recursive time migration in the space frequency domain. Recursive meaning like iteration. Make this, and then from this value, you go to another, and so on. When there are changes in velocity laterally, the previous methods will fail, and we need to apply the present method, this one. The present method used also the phase shift operator. So all these methods are integral in nature. The present method used also the phase shift operator discussed earlier. Then assumes the region can be subdivided into smaller areas with assumed homogeneous velocity, like this model. So the subsurface, according to velocity structure, can be approximated, and all our work is approximation of the subsurface. For 1D case, as flat, horizontal, homogeneous isotropic layer. This is what 1D case mean, velocity change only with depth. But when we have lateral variation, we move to this one in terms of blocks. Okay, we can assume at each of these blocks, we have constant velocity, or even we can define the subsurface as nodes, and the velocity between each two successive nodes is interpolated according to certain interpolation scheme. Meaning, suppose if in node representation. Suppose here we have the velocity is 500 meter per second, and here the velocity is say 300 meter per second. So the linear interpolation, if I want to estimate the velocity here at the point between these two nodes, so the linear interpolation means that we sum this one and this one and divide by 2, which is equal about 400 meters. Here is 300, here is 500, and we have this line, and we can interpolate velocity along this line. This is called interpolation. So this is far more, the nodes representation is far more complex than the block method. So here we are speaking about we can assume small blocks having homogeneous velocity, and we are going to use this homogeneous blocks with homogeneous velocity for migration. So we are going to apply here, and then go here, and then until we finish all the picture. This is an example. This is cycles, where this is amplitudes. Here it's this wave numbers, cycles mean wave number, and this is x inverse inverse transformation, and this how we optimize using the recursive time frequency method for migrating the seismic data. Here the caption says amplitude and phase of the two-dimensional homogeneous phase shift operator in the wave number domain. The solid line is a true operator. The dashed line is the optimized short version. Below the third panel here is the inverse Fourier transform of the optimized operator to the space domain. And here we can see we have good correlation at the zero position we are looking for. So the steps we are using, we have any problem here? First, we create short operator for different velocities and the frequencies and store them in a table, like the one you have did in your stacking velocity. Start with zero offset data at surface in the frequency domain. Apply. Now we are not working in KX, KY domain. Apply an extrapolation to depth level delta Z for all frequencies using space-dependent operator. Then select the time equal zero component of the inverse extrapolated result, which is the migrated result at that depth level. Then repeat the recursive extrapolation and imaging for each depth level. Finite difference time migration, and here we moved from the first integral method into the finite difference method. And the finite difference method is that we are applying, it's a numerical technique, applying the definition or using the definition of differentiation to extrapolate or to predict the value of the function. Say function f of x or the differentiation of the function f of x, the first differentiation, equal to something, say 2x plus say 5, and assuming that f of x at 0 equals something, say 1, you can just make use of this definition, f dash of x equal f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. Here we have limit where delta x goes to 0. You just assume, just take this one, okay? And you use, you remove this one, this limit, and you use, say for f of 1, you have the value at 0, and you have delta x to define f of x, delta x, and so on until you end with the last values you want. Okay? So I will give you or send you on the e-learning and the blend space something to define this. Okay? Because it's a course in itself. So it means that from knowing at certain point, we can find the value at x plus delta x and x plus 2 delta x and so on until we reach the surface. This method is unlike previous techniques discussed. Previous were based on integral solution to the wave equation, while the present one is differential approximation to the wave equation. In this method, the equation is approximated at time-space increment. The wave field is then estimated in the finite difference sense starting from certain assumptions. Certain assumptions of the values of, say, for amplitude, for time, and velocities. This method is good for gentle lateral variation in velocity. The basic point here is a step in both time and space. So the problem here is the choice of this step, the delta x. If we choose large delta x, we will be in under migration. If we choose small, very small delta x, we'll have high computational cost. The final one is the finite difference depth migration. In this case, we have strong lateral velocity variation. In this case, depth migration is more desirable. And why? Because if you have strong lateral variation in velocity, time domain may give me false structure. And most of us are aware of working with time section for structure. Suppose this is the situation. We have the reflector, like here, no structure at all. Okay. This is depth. And suppose we have lateral variation in velocity due to may change in lithology, maybe change in lithologic condition during to precipitation. So suppose we have, for example, three blocks here, this V1, V2, and V1 again. And suppose that V2 is less than V1. If we transform this into time section, the situation will be something like that. V2 is less, so we'll have something like that. So this in time domain. Due to the effect of velocity change, lateral velocity change. So let me assume this in time section as a structure and start working, and I'm having, say, basin, I have syncline or any sort of structure. While this structure actually is not present, it's absent. We have only change in velocity, in interval velocity and velocity in this region, and we have no structure at all. So we go forward for finite difference depth migration. In here we apply new factor which is called lateral velocity, and this lateral velocity is introduced in the finite difference representation to be applied for solving the migration. So the depth migration is more dependent and more sensitive to the velocity model. So if the velocity model I have is not correct, I will end up with very bad migration. Structure may not appear, will be disappeared or vanish, or some structure will be fake one visible on the depth migrated section. So we have to take care, and we have to know when and where to use each of the migration techniques we have. Finally, we have some comparison between the advantage and disadvantages of these techniques. For the Kirchhoff time migration, the advantage is simplicity. It's very simple, and it's based on NMO velocity directly, can handle steep depths, and adaptable to unusual source-receiver geometries. Whereas the disadvantages are it cannot handle low signal to noise ratio, it cannot handle lateral velocity variations, it's, it gives improper amplitudes, and we have the possibility of having spatial aliasing. For the finite difference migration, time migration, it can handle slow lateral variation velocity, it can handle low signal to noise ratio, whereas it's slow in computational speed, cannot handle depths over 45 degrees. So if I have dip more than 45 degrees, I'm not going to use such a method. Also cannot handle complex media. Migration by Fourier transform, fast in computational speed, able to handle steep depths, can handle low signal to noise ratio, but cannot handle lateral velocity variation. Finally, depth migration, in comparison with time migration, can handle vertical and lateral velocity variation, can handle steep depths, but the disadvantages is it requires accurate interval velocity model, slow in computational speed. Thank you. And if you have any comments, you can collect and start with tomorrow, inshallah. Because we are already outside the time. Thank you.